are now tuned in to recording live by here on RadioDR.co.zn.
I might just pull up now again. I might just
boy on the road, I might just pull up again. Since I'm a Simba again, pull up.
Reporting live, Ngakini, it's your boy MJ, holding it down, city to city, titty to titty. I have the beautiful, the lovely, the gorgeous, Kwandi, aka Uthamiya Ngakini, today holding it down, city to city, titty to titty. Ladies. Your queen is here. She about to shit on you. Kusazan, I met you a year ago because of the conjunction thing. Shout out to my nigga Simpi. We need you on the show, nigga. Shout out to my nigga Simpi during that event, the conjunction experience. Got to know you. I was like, oh fuck, this girl is like so beautiful and she's so talented and she's shitting on all you hoes.
Oh wow.
Fast forward.
I wasn't expecting that shit.
Fast forward. A year, that was last July. Fast forward a year and some change.
Dude.
You want Moja Love on the channel and shit on acting and shit. Hey, boys! The Nobola price just went up on you niggas. Fine. The Nobola price just went up on these niggas. Reporting live again at the SMP Mansion. What's the sign?
Hello.
Bruh, do these niggas have any idea?
No, I don't. What idea? What are you talking about, dude?
What's you shitting on these hoes?
No, I'm actually trying to shit on them, but I've got toilet paper and I've got sanitizer. I'm ready.
The shit out of my shit. You got me. It's your boy, Jesus. Sanitize this.
Yeah.
So, for those who don't know, let the people know where you're from. Let the people know when the acting thing started, and let the people know what's going on with this like series that you're a part of, shitting on these holes on TV and shit. The fuck?
Okay, so I'm from Mlazi, born and fucking raised there. I'm actually studying drama. I actually studied journalism first in 2017, 2018.
Yeah.
Hated the crap out of that. So I dropped out without my parents knowing. And I secretly applied for drama and then I got taken. Everyone in Kaya was expecting me to fail.
Oh.
Because I'm doing my second gen now. Honestly speaking, they were just not, they were against the whole drama thing. They were just like, enzi journalism, is a figure and I'll phone get a corner, but at least enzi just sort it out to some settings. Which is crap, because it was flipping boring. Because imagine sitting in a class full of passionate people and you there with earphones and shades on.
Oh, well, man.
That was my life. That was, it was horrible.
But were the shades on because Lampabu man's, or were they like...
Yeah, sometimes, but most of the time it's just like Stevie Wonder, the whole vibe, because I was not there mentally. Yeah, but and now I'm doing my second year. Got drama.
Shout out to DUT.
And I'm an actress on Erased, Moja Love.
Woo.
One of the main actors. I act like a freaking moron. She is freaking dumb. That character is dumb. She is, she's irritating. She's nothing like me, but. Yeah, I liked playing that character.
Like, let us know how you got that role. Like, who was the connects? Like, what happened? Like,
since at school we're theater based school. So what happened was it was actually during lockdown. So they were just distributing like izinto zama audition. Okay. Who can sing, dance, and act? And everyone automatically said, oh, Tamiya can. And immediately after, I got a phone call from the director of Erased, and he called me and he was just like, oh, do you want to audition? I was like, oh, I don't have a problem. In my head, I was already told, Uti, there's like half the country already auditioned for that role. So in my head, I was like, let me just do this for fun because I probably won't get another opportunity to audition. And then I did, and about like what 2-3 weeks later, I got a phone call from the producer telling me that, oh, you got the role, so I'm gonna be expecting you to come to Johannesburg to shoot the show.
Got the check.
I remember myself getting drunk every day after that.
So would I.
I got drunk every day after that, but yo, dude, when I got to Johannesburg, it was like work. I won't lie to you, I had no time for other stuff. I was just focused on what I had to do because I didn't want to disappoint. It's my first time.
So you want to
make sure I just needed to make sure, Wuti, I make a good impression of the people that are going to make sure, Wuti, I get other jobs. Because director, bayabuzana ukuthi bekunjani ukusebenza nalo sibanibani. So I needed to make sure I leave like an impact on those people. And you know, I'm voice shy because I was forced to actually sing and dance, and I'm comfortable with dancing because I'm a choreographer as well.
Woo,
so I was comfortable with acting and dancing, but then when they had to, they were just like, okay, your character sings a lot. I was like, crap, I'm not ready for people to hear me sing. And when I did, it was pretty cool because I actually got the opportunity to write my own songs for the show and sing them on the show. But I didn't write them as Samia, I wrote them as my character name was Imreen. So they're a bit different to what I'd normally sing or write, but it was good for me because now I'm writing more songs than I normally do. I dance more comfortably. I realize that I actually enjoy doing everything, being a performer, being within everything in the media industry. So when I started that within the show, I told myself that I don't want to stop. So
press that Beyonce button on these hoes. Press that Alicia Keys button on these acts.
I
sing,
think you're ready for dance, this challenge. I don't think you're ready for this. I don't gotta
I'm shitting on these hoes because I'm shitting on them fully.
No,
But like, how has the response been? Like, can you still walk through the mall?
No.
Can you still walk through it? How's the response been ever since you started that series?
Okay, so I'm not really a public person. I don't normally post on Instagram. I'm not really a social media type of girl. I keep to myself most of the time. So ever since the show, I still think of myself as myself. I'll walk around in my sweatpants, in my vest, in my shorts, and anything that I'd like to wear that I feel comfortable in. And then you're going to bump into someone. So losing humble no my more. Be like, and then Uma would literally have to stand aside, like after every 15 minutes, we bump into someone, or somebody, we're sitting at a restaurant, we're eating, be like, someone, I can't even have fun without having people wanting to take a picture with me. It's nice. I won't lie. It's a nice thing.
Nice life problems. Ngakini.
It's like, can I please drink in peace? Can I please enjoy my time and my family?
Peace, man. Just all imagine. Please, hey.
Even at Mushana Wami's birthday in Pietermaritzburg, they were just like, I might not know where I know you from, but I know your face is on TV. It's like, wow. Even my neighbors are my name is not my name anymore. It's weird because why am I changing my name now? You know? But it's really cool. I won't lie. I'm having a blast. I just want to finish school I can do more. But I'm really, really opening up to the music thing.
But like, how far are you willing to monetize from this shit though? Like, how far are you willing to get guap from it? Because we were talking about like you having your own clothing company.
Said that, not me. You said that, not me.
We are fancy financial advisor, creative director, fancy brand manager, Ngakini. Bro, you should like monetize off of this shit fully and completely.
Yeah, the thing is, I feel as if I've got like a lot of talents, so I can use that as well to get a lot of guap. So I'm glad I'm not a model.
Even like modeling, you're tall enough for it.
Yeah, but I'm fat as fuck for that.
Come on, bro. Shout out to all my plus size mommies. I love y'all. There's different kinds of modeling, bro.
Yeah, I understand.
There's like facial modeling, like for the cosmetics, none.
I eat like a pig. I can't be modeling.
Why don't you get like a talent agent?
I do have an agent.
I got
an agent now because of acting, but I got an agent that helps me with other stuff. But right now, I just want to make sure that I finish my
contracts with these motherfuckers.
No, it's school. I want to finish my thing at school.
When's season two dropping?
Yeah, that's gonna be confirmed actually at the beginning of the year.
Woo, so we're gonna get them guap again.
We're not sure, hey, but we're waiting for that phone call. Moja Love, call us, please.
Woo!
Moja
so
Love,
we can start 2021 the right way. Love,
because we need to know when are we going to be working. Okay. Thank you, love. So thank you.
how was it like working on set with these people, bruh?
It was amazing. Oh my gosh, it was so cool. Mm. Especially because I was one of the rookies. Not one of them. I think I was the only rookie there.
Fair.
I was the only rookie. I was working with Utina Chaka, Zetu Lomo, Mbali, Mbebe. And it's just like, yo, guys, it was a lot of greatness. I was surrounded by so much greatness. Yo, it was amazing.
Did you feel the pressure?
I did on the first day. But after a couple of hours on that first day, I realized that I'm not there for them. I'm here for me.
Fair.
And then I started doing my own thing. Because they were convinced that I was an 18-year-old girl when I arrived on set.
2000.
They literally believed Wutsinje. No, they just got me straight out of high school. And I got lucky enough to get the job. And I was like, no, I'm actually 22. And I'm studying drama.
The lobola price just went up on these niggas.
Oh, ma. Don't put a ring on it. It ain't
going to work. You know niggas, bro.
It's my decision if I want to take the lobola or not. I'm not going to get married.
All of them feel like, how am I going to get married? For Vilmusha and his cold. Keep a game in. He's at the same garden. Keep a game in.
That's how niggas feel like.
But like, let the people know what agency you're using, or what's the name of the company?
Viva Le Artis.
Viva Le Artis. Mm-hmm. What's the Instagram handle, bro? Because like, do they specifically handle access, or is like, no main?
If you're talented and you believe that you're talented enough to actually make it in the industry, they'll make sure that you showcase whatever you got. You know, because the founder of the thing is actually my friend and my lecturer from DUT. To be honest with you, I was a little scared of the lecturer. I still am scared of him, actually. Hi, Caesar. I'm still scared of him.
hey, nigga.
Like, he's the one that actually allowed me to... There was a Zulu production at school called Romeo and Juliet. And
I think I saw your post on
this. Yeah, Ulomeo no Juliet was translated into Zulu. And I'm not really a Zulu person, but they gave me the role of... Umala Juliet.
Mawaki. So you had to put like makeup to be old and stuff.
No, there was no old makeup at all. It was what was important, because it was a stage play.
It was what I said, and how
I portrayed myself. Because they had to differentiate between me and the character. And I won't lie, it was hell. An entire month trying to transition from
girl
to...
I feel like plays are worse than movies, are worse than TV.
Yeah, TV is...
Recorded,
it's not even recorded. You can simply say cut and start again.
And
they give you the script or prompt you while you're in the scene. When you're on stage, you need to make sure you know all 200 pages of the script. You need to make sure that you know every line. If you personalize the line, you have to personalize it according to the script. So there's a lot of pressure on stage more than screen. Trust me, because what I had to learn for that stage play is nothing compared to the stage play was hell. It was gazaga. I think I lost 10 kgs. I went from being a size 34 to a size 28 within 2 months. No sleep. You are stressing out because everyone... And yeah, boy, it was a class production, so everyone's like laughing at me. Angwaz kulumizul bangaz. You see, gee, this Lonnie, why was she given the
which do you prefer?
Character?
Okay, which do you prefer though, the play or TV?
I like challenges, both.
Both.
Yes. But I was more comfortable on screen. But yes. I don't want to lie, stage plays are fun because it's like freedom of expression.
You're performing every night.
Yeah. You
see the reaction of the crowd, man. It's okay, they're fucking with this, or okay, they're not feeling this.
Now, Kona Futsi, you shouldn't just feed off the crowd. You should understand and be in the moment within what you're doing. If the crowd, you the one, if you're on stage and you believe in what you're doing, you're making the crowd believe in what you're doing. So you feed off each other. So you feed off each other's energy. So if they're communicating with what you're doing, it gives you life. You don't have to exaggerate what you're doing, but it pushes you to, you know, execute it the way it's supposed to be. The way you feel like it's supposed to be, because no one can tell you that you're doing the wrong thing, because you know, since you develop the character throughout the process, so you know what you have to do. So Muflopo, you're the only one that's going to know what to flop in. Other people won't. So that's the pressure that you have on stage. Stage is hard.
Shit. Do you think I could be a good actor?
No.
Denzel, nigga. John Wick.
I've got a feeling Brad that Pitt, while you're
Tom
acting,
Cruise.
You know what you do while you're acting? You'd be like, in the scene and be like, Ngakini.
You know I will.
I'm gonna feel that you do something like that during a scene.
You know I will. Ngakini. I'll begin my Denzel on first. My man, Leonardo DiCaprio, nigga. Michael D. Jordan.
Listen,
Denzel, I'm Jay. But because I know, bro, like, please repeat the name of your agents, whether, like, if people want to hire you for something, they can contact you, and then give the people your contact details, your social media handles like Facebook and Instagram.
Okay, so my agency is called Viva Le Artiste.
It's how do you contact them?
It's on Instagram. You can DM them on Instagram.
Viva Le Artiste. Yes. One word.
Viva Le Artiste.
Okay.
Yeah. So you can contact them on Instagram, Facebook, and you can email them as well. My social media platforms, it's Kwan Mathonsi on Facebook, Kwandi Mathonsi on Instagram, and do I have Twitter? Yeah, I do.
Oh.
And Twitter.
Follow me on Twitter.
Kwandi Mathonsi on Twitter as well. Yeah.
Okay,
yeah,
so.
Yeah, like, if you want to contact me personally, use email.
Our business will keep it in the middle.
Mathonsi@gmail.com.
Reporting live again, it's a poem chain, holding it down. City. Shout out to Wonko Meshane, this short thing, Raise Life. If you're watching this right now, post some Raise
Life. Wow.
Raise Life, baby. Preferably, I'm a back order, I'm a plant raps. It's your poem chain.
He's
holding it down. City. Shout out to Deeply Rooted. Shout out to the CEO, shout out to the whole team, shout out to SMB reporting live again, shout out to your girl Tamir, oh
hello.
My, some tanda, let's go, oh my, again.
You are now tuned in to reporting live again on RadioDR.co.za.